Hello, I'm Eleanor Higgs.
And I'm Chris Carpinetti. And today we're going to discuss whether we should be worried about acrylamide being in our food.
Every so often, a molecule called acrylamide works its way back into the public sphere of attention, usually with warnings in tow about its presence in food and the apparent dangers it poses to your health. But how much of this is true, and should we be worried about it? Acrylamide is a natural byproduct formed during high temperature cooking, such as frying, toasting, or roasting of food products. Its creator is the Maillard reaction, the process that leads to the browning of food and the resulting distinctive flavor. In this reaction, sugars and amino acids react to form acrylamide, which is odorless and water soluble. When it's in the body, acrylamide is broken down to another molecule called glycidamide.
Acrylamide can be found in all sorts of cooked food products, but one of the biggest sources is thought to be fried potato products such as chips, French fries, and roast potatoes. It can also be found in toast, cookies, cereals, and coffee. But does this substance pose a health risk? There's an abundance of headlines suggesting that acrylamide in our food is bad for us and causes cancer. Many popped up after 2002 when the Swedish National Food Administration sounded a so-called alarm on the presence of acrylamide within food. Despite the concerns raised by that announcement over 20 years ago, there's simply not enough quality evidence, at least in humans, to directly support acrylamide causing cancer. This could be for a multitude of reasons. The first being that there's been some difficulty in figuring out how much acrylamide people are taking in based on their reported diets.
Then there's the matter of ethical boundaries, as to be able to really say that this causes cancer, you need to do clinical trials. But you can't do clinical trials with things that are possible carcinogens. That being said, there's enough animal evidence that some authoritative bodies believe it warrants further investigation. For example, in studies of rats, there's been evidence to suggest that acrylamide can lead to DNA or chromosomal damage and defects in the repair of that damage, common features that can lead to cancer. However, there have also been some toxicology studies that show humans and rodents both absorb acrylamide at different rates and metabolize it differently, so the animal findings don't necessarily translate to us.
In 2015, the European Food Safety Authority conducted a risk assessment of acrylamide in food. Evaluating the available scientific data, it delivered a scientific opinion on the matter with the following conclusions. Animal studies demonstrate that acrylamide and glycidamide are DNA or chromosome damaging and potentially cause cancer. However, there's limited evidence from human studies to suggest dietary intake of acrylamide increases our risk of cancer. The level of dietary exposure to acrylamide could be a concern, at least in terms of causing abnormal cell growth, for public health if further quality evidence in humans supports it, but currently levels of dietary exposure to acrylamide aren't of concern when it comes to other health issues. While the US Food and Drug Administration says that the risk isn't clear, the US National Toxicology Program and the Joint Food and Agriculture Organization and the World Health Organization Expert Committee on Food Additives are of the opinion that dietary acrylamide does pose a human health concern.
Despite the evidence for human risk not being clear-cut, organizations still have advice on how to reduce the levels of acrylamide, should people wish to do so. This can include choice of ingredients. For example, fried potato products made from potato dough instead of fresh potato are estimated to contain around 20% less acrylamide. When it comes to coffee, the type of roast can also make a difference. Light roasts tend to contain more acrylamide than medium or dark roasts. Then there's how people cook at home. Air fryers, which have shot up in popularity in recent years, are thought to produce around 30 to 40% more acrylamide than deep oil fryers.
Regardless of the cooking method, the UK's Food Standards Agency recommends to aim for a golden yellow colour or lighter when frying, baking, toasting, or roasting starchy foods. That being said, if you'd like to continue eating burnt toast with reckless abandon, we're not going to stop you.
Thank you for watching IFL Science. Please subscribe for more videos like this.